What if Gaskin was not absent in the defeat of the Chiefs? Or what if there was a great RB replaced Gaskin in his absence? Are you sure the Chiefs can beat the Dolphins? Not impossible. If there was one more classy running back like Gaskin, things would be different, and Dolphins' playoff picture was also very different. Let's see what Myles Gaskin has brought to the Dolphins the matches he plays. Gaskin had 14 carries for 87 yards during Saturday night's 26-25 win over the Raiders. He also secured all 5 of his targets for 82 yards and 2 touchdowns. From free agency to the draft to the NFL trade deadline, the Miami Dolphins failed to address one of their biggest needs and are paying for it. So, I really think, Dolphins need a running back right now. This is one off the best 2020 NFL draft running back. Running back Najee Harris. He ranks at number 3 among running back for the 2021 NFL draft, according to Pro Football Focus. They used to call Najee Harris the Enigma. He sits behind Javonte Williams, North Carolina, and Travis Etienne, Clemson, despite Harris leading the NCAA for rushing touchdowns, 24. Alabama RB Najee Harris, born March 1998. He's 6'2" high. 230-pounder totaled back-to-back 1,000-yard campaigns, as he recorded 1,262 yards on 214 carries. After posting 1,224 yards rushing in 2019, Harris showed improved speed, pass-blocking skills and fine-tuned his abilities at receiver. He caught 32 passes for 316 yards with 3 scores. Something's about Harris' career. As a freshman, Harris played in all 14 games but had limited carries as players like Damian Harris, Bo Scarborough, and Josh Jacobs handled the main workload. Harris finished the season with 370 yards on 61 carries, averaging 0.1 yards per carry. He also scored 3 rushing touchdowns. In his sophomore season, Harris was 3rd on the depth chart behind Damian Harris and Josh Jacobs. Harris played in 15 games, recording 783 yards and 117 carries and scoring 4 rushing touchdowns. Harris had his best game against Arkansas State, carrying the ball 13 times and gaining a career-high 135 yards. With Damian Harris and Josh Jacobs off to the NFL, Harris became the starting running back for Alabama Crimson Tide. During this season, Harris had 1,224 yards and 13 touchdowns while catching 27 passes for 304 yards and 7 touchdowns. Despite speculation that he would declare for the 2020 NFL draft, Harris announced that he would return to Alabama for his senior year. And in 2020, Harris was the starting running back for the Alabama Crimson Tide. Against Missouri, he had 17 attempts for 98 yards and 3 touchdowns. Against Georgia, he ran for 31 attempts with 152 yards, 1 touchdown and 4.9 yards on average. His best game was against Ole Miss, where he got 23 rush attempts for 206 yards, 5 touchdowns and a 9.0 yard average. About Harris' style, the number 3 prospect in the 2017-247 composite kept his recruiting process shrouded in mystery. Back then, 18-year-old Harris was the furious product of a tumultuous upbringing, his one source of stability the notion of pummeling opposing football players with reckless abandon. 3 years later, the Alabama running back runs with that same rage. But he's not a mystery anymore. Between his ascent through the program's list of all-time greats and his choice to thrust himself into the social spotlight, Harris is redefining the experience of today's top-tier college athlete. On the football side, he's a potential Heisman Trophy finalist and within reach of surpassing Derrick Henry as Bama's all-time leading rusher. With 2,475 career yards, Harris is 1,117 yards shy of that mark. Harris's offseason gains from training with former Auburn running back Brad Lester, which included racing against drones, were evident in Saturday's 3-touchdown, 5.8 yards per carry performance against Missouri. Harris's 98 yards moved him into 14th on Alabama's career charts. "I didn't even know I was on track to do that until I got tagged in something after the game," Harris said this week. "It ain't really a goal, it's not my personal goal. My personal goal is to really be more of like a spokesman person because I suck at that right now with my teammates. I'm not really that type of guy to be in front of people and, like, talk. I'm not really that type of guy. It's that transformation that truly sets Harris apart."